Now we add clothes. Select this edge loop and extrude it. Move it down and scale to match the reference. Well, this is one way to add clothes, that is, we extruded it from the base mesh itself. So there is only one single mesh. However, we can make separate objects for each item as well. Let's do that for our practice. Select this edge loop. Press Shift D to duplicate it. Press Escape or right click to confirm the position of the new duplicated points. While these are selected, press P and make the selected vertices a separate mesh. Select the new object and press Tab to enter edit mode. Now extrude this to make the skirt. Extrude, scale and move the points. Match the reference from side view also. Now get back to the base mesh and in the edit mode select the vertices suitable for shirt. Press Shift D to duplicate it and P to make it a separate object. Now tweak the mesh in the edit mode. Extrude the lower part. turn off do clipping and push this last point a bit. Turn back do clipping on. Some more tweaking and shaping. Now we make another new mesh with the shirt object being the base. Select these vertices, Shift D to duplicate, and finally P to make it a separate object. Extrude and bring out the color. Bring these a bit closer. Now extrude from the back side. Add a loop cut and pull it up a bit. Now we make the bow. Select any edge and duplicate it. Bring it down. And start extruding, following the shape. Adjust it from the side view as well. Select all vertices of the bow and extrude it to give a thickness. Loop cut an edge and scale it a bit to give a nice roundness, else the bow will look like a solid block. Shape and tweak some vertices. Duplicate the whole bow and place it behind. Scale down and make it thinner than the upper bow. Add a small cylinder. And place it in the center. Separate the whole bow thing from the collar mesh. Extrude an edge downwards. Select the skirt and new objects and press Set Smooth in the editing button panels. If you get these lines, press Ctrl N in the edit mode. What actually happens is the normals of some faces are pointing in the wrong directions. You can select these faces and press Flip Normal. Or select all and press Ctrl N to recalculate the normals. Save the file. For the hairs, select the upper portion of the skull. Duplicate it and make it a separate object. Scale it up. Select the front row of vertices and extrude them down. Select the back part and start extruding downwards. With each extrude, scale the points along the X axis to align them. Tweak the points and add vertices where necessary. Now press Apply button in the mirror modifier, as now we will not be modeling in symmetry. Select this point and press V to cut it out. Similarly, do this for all vertices of this line and back. give it a non-symmetrical look. Tweak the upper line. Now select the edge and start extruding it down, scaling and moving to give a nice shape and a non-symmetrical look. Select this top face. Duplicate it and make it a separate object. Select the new mesh and start extruding it. Scale, move and rotate to shape it. Add a mirror modifier. Save the file. Just spread out the main volume of the hair, make them wider. Extrude some more edges. Now select all the vertices of hair by pressing A key and press E to extrude. This gives a nice volume to the hair. Tweak and match the points. Save again.